video demonstrates how to resolve the following browser SSL certificate warnings. Your connection is not private, or this site is not secure, or potential security risk. When connecting with HTTPS to the Checkpoint Security Gateway or Management Server web user interface. The reason for this warning is that the certificate which the security gateway or management present to your browser is signed by the management's internal CA and the browser does not recognize it. We can replace the certificate with an SSL certificate that we purchased from an established and trusted certificate provider, or with a certificate issued in our organization by our certificate authority server. In the latter case, you will have to make sure that the organization root CA certificate is installed in the client certificate store. There are two different procedures to replace the certificate for two different cases. The first is for a security gateway that uses multi-portal. The second is for security gateway which does not use multi-portal, for security management, or for multi-domain management server. In the first scenario, the security gateway's platform is also used for other blades, such as mobile access portal, identity awareness, captive portal, and so on. The multi-portal daemon is used to decide which process should handle the incoming SSL connection. In order to check if the MP daemon is up and servicing other portals, run MP client list in the gateway's expert mode console. The certificate change in this case is straightforward. Open the Security Gateway Properties in Smart Console, click on Platform Portal, and under Certificate, click to import a certificate. Now select a new certificate. In this demo, I am installing a certificate from my organization's internal CA. I can verify the new certificate fingerprint, then publish and install policy. If the certificate is from your organization's CA, it might show that the site is trusted on Firefox and on other browsers, while in Chrome it will still show the privacy error. If Chrome displays the cert common name invalid, and in advanced it says that the certificate does not specify subject alternative names, it is because Chrome, since version 58, no longer uses the common name field to validate an SSL certificate, but only uses the subject alternative name field. Make sure you add the DNS name for the alternative name in the certificate enrollment properties. The second procedure is for security management server, multi-domain management server, or for a security gateway without the multi-portal feature. In this case, the certificate and the private key which are used for the Gaia portal are located in the /web/conf directory on the machine. We want to convert the certificate we have from P12 or PFX format to separated .key and .crt files. But first, we want to back up the original certificate and private key. I have copied the original P12 file to the machine. To extract the private key from the P12 file, I will use the cpopen_ssl command with the following syntax. I am required to enter the P12 file password and to create a new passphrase for the .key file. To extract the certificate from the P12 file, I use cpopen_ssl with the following syntax. Again, I am asked to enter the P12 password. Let's view the private key file. If the key in the key file is encrypted, I will decrypt it with the following cpopenSSL command. The next step is to replace the original certificate and key files in the webconf directory with the new ones we extracted. Running ls-l, I can see the date of the server.crt and server.key has changed. What is left now is to restart the Apache web server. First, I will check with the ps command that the httpd processes are running. Stop the web server with the tellpm command. And start the web server with the same tellpm command with t at the end. That's it. Now I access the Gaia WebUI and check the certificate presented by the browser.
Checkpoint. We secure the future.